Tamim al-Dowry, who was a Christian man, saw the Antichrist, the one-eyed liar, in the monastery, in a huge cave, where Allahu A'lam. He saw his hands tied to his neck. He had iron shackles between his legs up to his ankles. And the Dajjal, this liar, asked Tamim and his companions questions. He said to him, how is the date palms of Baysan, a place in Jordan, do they bear fruit? He asked him, how is the lake of Tiberias in Palestine? He says, what do you want to know about it? Does it hold water? He said, it holds a lot of water. It's full. Soon it will be empty. Soon it will be empty. Gog and Magog will gobble it down. Then he kept asking him questions until he reached and asked him, how is the unlettered prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? What has he done? Did the Arabs fight against him? Tamim said, yes, they fought against him. He goes, it is better for them to follow him. It is better for them to follow him. Alhamdulillah, we are the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the one-eyed liar speaking. This is the Antichrist speaking. This is the Dajjal in himself speaking, saying it is better for them to follow him. Are you not happy that you are a follower of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He's a liar, but he spoke the truth. This liar is a liar, the biggest liar, he's a devil. Yet he's spoken the truth. It is better for us all to follow him. Then he said, I'll tell you about myself. I am the Dajjal. I will soon be permitted to leave this place. I will travel the earth. I will have 40 days in which I will pass through every single town except Mecca and Medina. Every time I try to enter either one of them, I will be met by an angel bearing an unsheathed sword, uncovered sword, preventing me from entering it. He is from among the offspring of Adam, this Antichrist, this one-eyed liar. He will be given 40 days, but one of those days will be like 1 year. Another will be like 1 month. A third would be like 1 week. And the rest of the days would be like our normal days. He was described as being huge, a huge man, red complexion, short curly hair, one eye. The other eye looks like a floating grape. Between his two eyes written kafir. Kafir, the dirtiest word that can ever be written. Everyone can read it except the kafir. Every single Muslim will be able to read this word, literate or illiterate, except those who are not believers, except those who will follow him. He mentions, sallam, that no tribulation on earth since the creation of Adam will be worse than the tribulation of this liar of the Dajjal. He will begin by saying, I am your prophet, but there will be no prophet after me, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. Then he will claim that he is the Lord, he is your Lord, but you will not see your Lord until you die. He will be given the authority, the power over one man, whom he will kill and then cut in two for sword. He will say, look at this slave of mine. I will resurrect him. And he will still claim that he has a Lord other than me. So Allah Ta'ala will resurrect him. And the Dajjal will ask him, who is your Lord? He will say, my Lord is Allah. Allah. What a beautiful saying. Who is our Lord? Our Lord is Allah Ta'ala. And he will say that you are the enemy of Allah Ta'ala. My Lord is Allah, and you are the enemy of Allah. You are the Dajjal. And he will say, by Allah, I have never been more sure of this than I am today. And Muhammad ﷺ said about this person, he will have the highest status among my Ummah in paradise. Wouldn't you like to be this person? SubhanAllah. Yani wallahi, we should be doing dua day and night to be this person. Imagine being that person, just imagine it. How beautiful. The greatest martyr and the highest person in paradise. Who are his followers? The majority of his followers are Jews. One narration says 70,000 Jews. And likewise, Arabs. The narration mentions Arabs will be a lot of his followers, the ignorant Arabs. As for his death, it will be time for Salat al-Fajr, when Isa ibn Maryam will descend. And he will descend wearing two garments dyed in saffron, placing his hands in the wings of two angels. As he's descending, he lowers his head. Beads of perspiration will fall from it. If he raises his head, beads of pearls will scatter from it. His fragrance, every kafir that smells it will die. And it can be smelt, his breath, as far as he can see. His descendants, Isa alayhi salam, a whole group of Muslims gathered together, ready to fight the Dajjal. It will be Salat al-Fajr, and the Iqamah will be just about to be announced when the leader of this prayer of the congregation will be Al-Mahdi. He will step back when he notices Isa coming down, and he will tell Isa, please lead us in prayer. But Isa will place his hands between the shoulders of the Al-Mahdi, and he will say, pray, for the prayer has been made or announced for you. So Al-Mahdi prays, and after the prayer, Isa alayhi salam says, open the gate. The gate will be opened, and behind that gate will be no other than this one-eyed liar with an army of Jews. And there, they will be bearing, all of them, a sword and a shield. The Antichrist, when he sees Isa alayhi salam, he starts dissolving like salt dissolves in water, and he run away. But Isa will call out and say to him, you will not die until I strike you with my sword. So he will meet up with him on a gate called the Eastern Gate of Ladd. This is all in the Middle East. And there, Isa alayhi salam will strike him with his sword, and he will die. He will die. And all the Jews, his army, will be deflated. Thus, Isa and the companions will win over these evil people, and they will at the same time do dua, pray for Allah Ta'ala to destroy Gog and Magog, because Gog and Magog will be in that time. After that, peace and security will prevail on earth, whereby the lions will graze with the camels, the tigers with the cattle, the wolves with the sheep, the kids will be able to play with snakes without coming to harm, wealth will be in abundance, no one will care about it, the rain will come down in abundance, the earth will bring forth its blessings, a cow will supply for a whole tribe, and a sheep will supply for a whole family. There will be no enmity between two persons after this, and Isa alayhi salam will not come with any new laws. Instead, he'll be a follower of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For indeed, the deen of Islam is the end of all deens. Allah Ta'ala will end every sect, every religion other than Islam. Isa alayhi salam will kill the pig, abolish jizya, and break the cross. And thus, he will live for 40 years. He will die, he'll be preyed on and buried by the Muslims.